All right. I want to welcome everybody to our first Digital Skills for Everyday Tasks training session. We are going to get started here in about 5 minutes, give folks the time to join us. We have people coming to us from a variety of different locations. So if you are in Discord, hello. If you are on watching us on a recording, hello. If you are joining us in Google Meet and you are live, hello. Wherever you are, I should be able to see any comments that you have, so please do not hesitate to pop those in. And while you're thinking about your digital skills and acquiring skills, I want to let everybody know that we have a whole series coming up of some really cool tips and tricks that are going to help you to become not only more effective in your day-to-day, but also more effective at work. And so we are calling these skill builders. We are a Grow with Google company. And so I'll go through all of that shortly, but did want to let everybody know we're going to get started right in a couple of minutes at 10:05. So five after. So just hold tight, get those questions ready to go. And we will get started here shortly. Okay, thank you. Oh man, I'm just talking on mute. Okay, so let's start over. I am delighted to have all of you here with me today. My name is Nicole Maxwell, and I'm the CEO of Black Multiverse Enterprises and the founder of a community called Blackverse. And so, wherever you are joining us, I am so happy that you're here and that you are taking advantage of what we are doing. What we are doing is providing Google training to people so that they can understand and begin to skill up in some free-to-use resources that can be life-changing if you know how to use them. And so the reason we're doing that, Black Multiverse is a, and that is Multiverse, Black Multiverse Enterprises is dedicated to ensuring that, the disenfranchisement that we see in the present doesn't make its way into our future. And so everything that we do is really dedicated to trying to ensure that, including the Blackverse community, which is dedicated to decentralization and making sure that people understand there are options out there in the metaverse. And so it's really important that we know what's coming. But in order to accept or understand what's coming and be able to build and create and cultivate, we have to be able to we have to be able to have space to think about things differently. And a lot of us are bogged down, like we're not in a position where we can actually enjoy discovering the metaverse or enjoy discovering what some of decentralization can look like, or what it can look like to operate when you don't have a boss and you are your own boss. You're in charge of your own future, your own lane. And so I wanted to do something different, and that was to give back. And I wanted to find partners that could help do that and could help disrupt some of this ridiculousness that goes on. And so we partnered up with Google. We first got some scholarships for folks, and then I realized the challenges behind that all on its own. And so eventually we also became a Grow with Google partner. And so that is what we are delivering today, is a piece of that partnership to help people to discover some digital skills for everyday tasks. So today we're going to learn a little bit about Google Sheets, Google Docs, and Google Slides. And so you're going to learn how to do some really cool things, and I'll get into that in a second. But yeah, welcome. You can always connect with us at blackmultiverse.io. You can also send us over an email at info@blackmultiverse.io, or you can reach out to us if you're on our Discord at that is going to be available at blackverse.io. And you can jump into our Discord and hang out with us there and discover the metaverse and see what that's all about. These courses we are going to be running every Tuesday and every Thursday throughout the end of the year. So we're making sure that we're creating space, and we're pretty serious about it. So it won't always be me that's presenting, but I'm definitely gonna be doing the first couple ones just to kind of get the kinks out, and then we're gonna move forward, and you'll see some of our other folks show up as time goes on. But I thank you so much for being here. One of our taglines, just to kick things off, is to never be limited by other people's limited imaginations. And that is a quote by Dr. Mae Jemison, the first African American astronaut. And she is a powerhouse. If y'all don't know her, go out and investigate, because what she does, or what she did at the time that she did it, was truly exceptional and extraordinary. And that's what I want to be, is exceptional and extraordinary. And so everything that I do, it's a little different than what people do. And I find that people kind of try to put their own flavor on it after I've rolled mine out. But I'm always creating, always innovating, and always trying to do something that is different. And so, this is definitely one of those things, because in Web3, you don't hear a lot about Google. Like, Google is kind of what we're trying to change, but I'm trying to make sure that we can use the skills and abilities that are at our disposal. While we are also beginning to expand our minds into what the future can bring and what that looks like. So anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with the actual presentation today. So thank you for tapping in once again. And we are not, I'm not gonna do that. Oops, so I just closed it. Give me a second, guys. I closed the wrong tab. That's all right, stuff happens. So just give me just a minute and I will go back and grab the actual presentation here. Sorry about that. So anyway, so if you wanna connect with us, you wanna connect with the Blackverse community, you are able to do that. And you can connect with us at blackverse.io. We are also available at blackmultiverse.io. So you're able to connect in either way. Okay. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. All right, so today we're gonna have a discussion about digital skills for everyday tasks. So welcome to the workshop. This is gonna be a hands-on workshop. So what I want you guys to do is to get comfortable and to actually like pull out two screens if you have them. That is gonna be the best way to tap in. If not, then just go to your Google Drive and you're going to be able to follow along with what we're doing. If I'm moving too slow, too fast, if I'm moving too slow or too fast, let me know in the comments. I can see comments from literally everywhere that we are streaming this. So please do not hesitate. If you get lost or stuck or you need further clarification, please let me know and I will happily provide that for you. All right. So we're gonna move on to the next one. All right, so let's talk a little bit about working remotely. So first of all, when you're working remotely, which is why you would want digital skills, right? If you're working at the office, you know, you usually have training, somebody's gonna provide you with that. But I think that, you know, we've seen a huge shift over the last several years and we've had to make some changes. And so let's be real. We all know that working remotely can really be a different thing than what we're used to. And so it is important that we have some skills and abilities to help us do that. Some tips for you. Just as a high level, it's gonna be important that you keep your routine. So don't change up your routine too much. If you wake up at 8 o'clock or you used to wake up at like 6 or 7, continue to do that in your work from home routine because it's gonna give you a sense of normalcy. Create a outlined dedicated workspace. Like I have actually shifted my entire office into my living room so it can be in front of my TV so that I have a constant buzz going on. And I mimic kind of what you would have seen in like an actual workspace. And so I don't like it to be too quiet. I need to have that constant sound so that I can just keep going. And so for me, that's what works. You got to do what works for you. So if you like, you know, fully peace and quiet, if you don't like bright light, I found that bright light was really helpful to me when I was working remotely as well. Or when I shifted to working from home. You also want to make sure that you're eating. It is so easy to forget to eat when you are sitting and kind of like enveloped in a project or kind of like on a vibe. You got to remember to eat because your health is extremely important. You want to make sure you got the tools to be productive. So whether that's a pen, a pencil, a pad, a laptop, a tablet, something that you can use when you're not at your little workstation. In the future, you're going to have your VR headset. So what does that look like? So make sure that you got the tools you need to be successful. Also think about creating a daily to-do list. So what does that list look like? How can you put that into your routine? So my routine wakes me up every day with my affirmations. And that's literally what makes me jump out of the bed, is the way that I have my Google Home Hub programmed to incorporate that. But then also, it is really important to me that I have some things that I'm trying to achieve that day. With that, it's really important to me that I also not beat myself up if I don't achieve those things. It's just like, that's my target. That's what I'm trying to do. And anything that I don't do obviously gets pushed over to the next day. Some people are very adamant that everything on that list has to get done or they don't go to sleep. I can't do that. So I got health issues. I need to sleep. So, you know, it is important that you do what's right for you, and just, you got to know yourself. So know yourself a little bit. This one, give your coworkers some grace. So you're taking this course, you're taking the, steps to step into the future and do something a little bit, more strategically aligned with advancement. They may not be doing that. They may be floundering. So offer them to come to one of these sessions. Offer them to any of the knowledge that you're getting, kind of share that with them, but then also give them just a little bit of grace. I know coworkers can be interesting, to say the least. So it's important that when your day is done, don't forget to stop working. Having a clear line between work and play is extremely helpful to keep things going and keep that sense of normalcy. All right, enough about that. So today we're going to be focusing on three digital skills that can make your everyday work life easier. So it doesn't matter if you're at home working remotely or if you are in a traditional office setting, these skills are going to help you to stay productive. So you're going to find a way to keep track of your to-do list. You're going to find ways to collaborate with your team, and then also to keep your organization and business partners updated about any progress that you may be making. So what does it look like to share that progress with someone else? We're going to demonstrate several digital skills that can help you with these different needs. So our example is going to be building a company summit. Who knew that Nicole Maxwell, the person who just got done doing the Blackverse Summit, is going to be telling you how to build out a company summit. But these skills and applications can apply to a variety of different work situations. So you might have something totally different that you're working on building. It's okay. The how-to is going to be the same. The inputs are going to be different. We'll build three example projects that demonstrate how to enhance your productivity and how to make progress on your work right now. All right, so these projects can boost your productivity immediately. So if you're a job seeker, the digital skills that you gain here are going to help you jump into the right kind of work. And did I say that Black Multiverse is hiring? Because Black Multiverse is hiring. So we've got some sales positions available. If anybody wants information on that, please reach out to me at info@blackmultiverse.io. All right, so let's go. All right, so we're going to be creating a to-do list with Google Sheets. We're also going to be creating a meeting agenda with Google Docs and building a presentation with Google Slides. At the end, I am going to provide you with a whole ton of resources so that you can dive into this stuff on your own. In Web3, we have a saying, and that is to do your own research. So you're going to go in and you're going to like learn everything that you can from me today, but then you're going to go out and try this on your own, and so that you can really kind of take those skills to the next level. All right. So Google Drive is a free cloud-based tool that allows you to store your files and your folders. So we're going to be using Google Drive. The applications that we're going to use are called Google Sheets, Google Docs, and Google Slides. And so I'm saying that in that way because a lot of folks do not know that Google offers this kind of thing. A lot of people are familiar with other product work suites and other applications, which I won't say what they are, but you know, you're used to using the corporate editions of those products. Well, Google has a whole entire suite of services and products that are available for you to use as well. So the skills that you cover today are going to be able to be applied in a multiple variety of different ways down the road. All right, so this is the part, this part right here. You're going to sign into your Google account. So do that right now. If you don't have a Google account, go ahead and sign up for one while we're talking. They are free. You can step through it right now while I am going through this information for you. So what you're going to do is sign in. So if you've never been to Google and you've never created an account on Google, I'm going to show you how to do that, all right? So you may already be a part of some event that's coming up. You might be hosting a digital video conference through Google Meet. You may have joined a conference. You may have had a consultation. So some of those tools that you've been on have definitely been Google products. We're going to practice using these tools in the context of planning an event, but you can apply these skills to different situations. I'm going to keep saying that because it's important. Just because I'm doing a summit and that's what I'm rolling out to you doesn't mean that that's the only use case for this, okay? For example, you can use a sheet to create a budget or to research a job plan. You can also use a Google document to create a resume or a cover letter, design a flyer, or brainstorm a big project, or use it to present a Google workshop. First, we need to access your application. So let's take an opportunity. Go ahead and sign into your Google account. So on screen, you're going to see your Google landing page. Now, depending on the day, your Google landing page might look slightly different. Google does tend to change the Google logo sometimes, and so that's normal and it's okay. But you're going to go to google.com, okay? And then up in the upper left-hand, right-hand corner, you should see sign in. So it should look very similar to this screen that you see right now. This is what you're used to using for search, and there's also Google Images and Gmail. But when you sign in, you get power and access to even more, okay? So you're going to go ahead and open a tab in your browser, go to google.com. If you're not already signed in, go ahead and do it. You're going to enter your username and your password. And so it'll look a little something like this. And your password screen is going to look a little something like this. Now, your password is not shown unless you want it to be shown. So as I said, if you don't already have a Google account, you can set one up for free. You can get a new Google address, a Gmail email address, or you can get another email address that you already have. So you can visit accounts.google.com/signup. So I didn't realize that. That's interesting. See, you learn something new every day. If your business or your employer uses Google Workspace, you may have an email address that doesn't look like a Gmail address, but you can still use it as a Google account. If you aren't sure if your email is a Google account from your job, just check with your team. So you should have an administrator that administrates your IT and your support stuff. They should be able to tell you if that is or is not a Google Workspace application. Well, what did I just say? That was a whole vibe. All right, so what did I just say? So let's talk about what you can do with your Google account. So inside of Google, there's something called your Drive. But before we get to that, there's also just standalone applications. So signing into your Google account allows you to access all of the products that you're going to learn about today. So you only have to sign in once, and it kind of retains that information. After you've signed into your Google account, you can use the apps menu to move between the applications. So the apps menu is this one right here. Okay, so that little kind of looks like a telephone dial pad. Okay, so you're going to find Sheets. You're going to find, let's go back to that. I'm going to go back. You're going to find Sheets. You're going to find Docs. You're going to find Slides, Photos, Chrome, which is your browser, and then Gmail. All right. So you're going to find all of those things, and you're going to be able to use them and just swap between applications. And so we'll show you how to do that. All right, so how do you access the Google Drive? Well, so to access Google Drive, you're going to be at your screen that looks like this. You're going to be signed in. Over here on the sign-in tab, you'll see your little icon or what we call an avatar profile image up here. That image means that you are signed into a particular account. Usually, it's going to pull the first letter of the name that was signed in. And then you're going to click on the apps icon, and so that's again that little dial pad. You're going to click on that, and then you're going to click on the drive to select the file. Okay, so you click once, and then you come down to drive, and it's going to be down here a little bit. So you've got all these different apps that you can access. So if you've never clicked on this before, definitely go in there and have some fun because there's apps there that are added all the time. All right, so you're going to click on the Drive button. So it's down here. All right, so we've got that circled for you. You can click on that. All right, so Google Drive allows you to access, store, and share files like your documents, your spreadsheets, your presentations, forms, and photos all in one place. Instead of it being stored on a computer, Google Drive saves your information to the cloud. All right, so after you save something on the drive, you can access it from anywhere because it's in the cloud. The cloud is that imaginary computer in the sky. You're going to be able to access it from there. Files stored on Google Drive don't get lost, even if your computer crashes, because it's stored in the cloud. Okay. The files you create with Google Apps are automatically saved in Google Drive, and you don't ever even have to click the save button. That was like revolutionary when they came out with that. It was like, thank you, God. All right. If you've never created anything with Google Apps before, your drive is going to be empty. Once you start creating files in the apps, you'll see them and they'll be stored there. Sometimes you'll see even recent things that are stored there. If you have a computer, a tablet, a smartphone, you can follow along if you wish. So maybe you don't have two screens, or maybe you are trying to multitask or something like that. You can put both of these on different screens. So you can follow along on like a phone, or you can follow along the video on the phone. So either way. All right, so let's get started. All right, so we've got an example project, and we're going to create a to-do list for our big event. Feel free to follow along with me or create your own version of what we're doing, but the point is to get active and to get started doing this, all right? So the first step in planning any major event is to figure out what you want to do, and that is to create a task list, okay? So figure out what needs to be done and who needs to do it. So that's what we're going to do. All right, so next step, you can create a new blank sheet for this work. Google Drive offers a library of great time-saving templates. A template provides access to something that is basic information, and it gets you started from a formatting standpoint. Google Sheets has a template that will do our to-do list nicely, and it's called the to-do list. So let's use that. Okay, so to get started on this, you can always click on Click New, and you can create your own. You can click on, and then you're going to choose Google Sheets. So you're going to click New, and then click Google Sheets, and then select from a template, and then click to-do list. Now, you don't have to do from a template. You can always create your own. And then in that case, you would just click create new and select template. Okay. All right. So we're going to go ahead and do that. So you're going to click new. This now ends our regularly scheduled broadcast. I hope that you enjoyed this viewing on BlackVerse TV and have a wonderful evening. Goodbye. Whoa. I'm not sure what just happened there. I think I'm still on Twitch. That's funny. sorry about that. I'm gonna have to edit that out. But All right, so we have access to Google Sheets. You're going to click New, click Google Sheets, and then click From a Template, and then click to do this. Okay, so we've already clicked New. You've clicked Google Sheets. Okay, so you click that, and then you get to choose from a template. If you just click once, it's going to open up a blank spreadsheet. But when you come here and click the actual arrow, it gives you the option to create from a template. And then up here at the top, you'll see the templates that are available to you. And you're going to click to-do list or here and click to-do list. Okay. All right. So the to-do list is now present and you have, your to-do list available to you, and that to-do list is going to allow you to go ahead and check out what it is that you are doing. So we are going to go ahead, and now that you've got a to-do list, this is the template for it. You're going to be able to populate your sheet with the information. So you're going to add tasks and then add some dates. So this template is going to look very different from a blank sheet. Okay, so I want you to focus on rows 7, 8, 9, and 10. So rows 7, 8, 9, and 10 allow you to see kind of what a blank sheet would look like, except these little checkboxes would not be here on a blank or blank a blank sheet. Okay, so when you're looking at a blank sheet, this is literally a spreadsheet, and that spreadsheet has been pre-populated with some data, and that's what we call a template. So remember that. Okay, the image on the slides allows you to do a to-do list. So let's go ahead and add in or let's look at the three selected tasks that are here. So our sheets contain rectangles, and these are called cells. Okay, so each of these is called a individual cell. Cells are organized into both columns and rows. Okay, so when you're looking at this, you're looking at the box here. When you look down, when you look down vertically, those are going to be rows. So you look down vertically, you see the numbers here. These are rows, and so these rows, like row 8, is right here. Okay, so the shaded row 4 is right here. All right, and then across the top, you have your columns. So A, B, C, those each are columns, and so spreadsheets are organized into columns and rows. All right. Each cell within a column or a row is indicated by where they join at. So every cell is named based on where it is on the spreadsheet. So every cell has a name, and if, for example, this first cell is A1. Okay, so you always give column first, and then you give the number A1. And so it is column A, row 1, and that's why it's A1. Vice versa, you can't really see it here. So this isn't, to me, I can give you a better example of this, but this isn't a great example. But B1 is actually right here. I don't know if we're going to talk about merge cells, but you often have what you're actually seeing on screen, which is the idea of merging some cells together. So it looks like this big old block of text here. But that's what we've got. All right, so you can navigate the sheet by clicking on different cells. And when you click on a cell, that cell is going to highlight. Okay, so you're going to see it highlight. As you add text, you can add text, you can add formatting, you can add functions. Now, functions are mathematical equations that get you to your end goal. That is far advanced from what we are talking about today. Okay. There are columns for check marks. So in column A, that is a column, and that column is indicate there's a check box inside of that column. Okay. You can check it off when you get done with that task for that specific row. Okay. So for example, if I were done with the task of changing the styling of completed items under format, which, you know, that's weird, but if I were done with that task, then I would go ahead and click that box, and it would add a check mark into it indicating that it's complete, okay? There's a space for a description and a task. So if you're looking at column 3, this is what we actually call our header row. And this row is telling you what is seen inside the data throughout the rest of that specific column until you hit another header, okay? So this one only has one header, and you're seeing that column A has a checkbox, column B, according to cell B3, has the date, and then cell C3 has a task. And so that's what you're seeing there, all right? All right, to use this template, what you're gonna do is replace the things that you need to do with your event or your project or your work. All right, so you're going to feel free to copy what you're seeing on screen. And you can just do this in the same exact way. You can copy it and then paste it in there. Or as an example, you are seeing that someone is typing and then they're copying and pasting and things like that. So you can replace what's in each of these cells with the information that actually corresponds to what you're trying to accomplish. So remember, we're creating an event, we're creating a corporate summit, but for this specific thing, you can tailor it to whatever you want to. So right now, they're changing it up, and you're seeing that it's changing to preparing the budget for review and then creating a meeting agenda. So each of those things are things that you can try to do. The dates, you can always change those. So just kind of try to stick something in there, and ultimately this will help you as you are creating your project. All right, so you are only one person, and oftentimes you don't do things all by yourself. So sometimes you have a team of people that you are working with. Other times you have cohorts that you need to get things out to, partners, vendors, all that information. So let's say that you wanted to collaborate with a bunch of people and then divide up the responsibilities to a committee or to a specific individual. You can add in another column, and that column is going to be entitled owner, all right? So write a name next to each row for each task. So you're assigning ownership with this. So these are the basics of project management too. You look at that, you're getting something for free. So now you can insert. So you're gonna right click. So you're gonna click on column C, and then you're gonna open the insert menu. So I'm gonna show you that real quick, hold on. So you're gonna click on column C, so then it's highlighted. Remember I told you anytime you click, it's gonna be highlighted, and that shows you what is selected. And then you're gonna click on insert, and then you are going to click insert one column. Now, when you do this and you go down to columns and you're choosing insert here, it's giving you options. So you can either insert to the left or to the right, depending on the type of information that you're wanting to add in. You have to decide that. So the Google Sheets is not going to decide that for you. You actually have to make that decision. All right. So you're either going to insert one column to the left or one column to the right. All right. So your new column D is going to appear. And so when you see that, we chose to do the right. So it's going to be added to the right. We're inserting it in here. Now, just a quick note on that word insert. You inserted it into the entirety of the spreadsheet. So that's what that meant. So sometimes people think that, oh, well, I chose insert, so it should go on the inside, but you also told it you wanted it on the right, which is the outside of the column that you selected. So it is adding it to the entire spreadsheet. Okay, so just be mindful of that. Your new column is column D, and so you see that right here. It comes in with the same formatting sometimes. So depending on what the formatting of the previous column was, it will come in with similar formatting in terms of text and things like that. Okay, so inside of cell D1, we're gonna go ahead and you're going to give it a title called owner, And then you're going to add some assign, you're going to assign some different information into each of these steps. So we're going to walk through that, watch the screen so you can see what's happening. So we added an owner, and now we're adding in each of our steps. So each of the owners is added in. So those are the people who are going to own each of these tasks, okay? So now you can also choose a color. So you can change the color that is filled here. So right now there's no color and there's also not, so it did not come in with the same formatting. So you've got nicely lined rows that are all the same color, whereas this one's just a white block. So you can change the font color, the size, and the style, all right? In order to do that, up here at the top, you've got your formatting bar. And so you can come up to your formatting bar or your formatting menu and click on the fill icon. And it looks like a little paint canister, and it's filling a color. All right, when you click on that, it's going to open up and then allow you to select from the different colors that are available, or you can come down here and add in additional color, come up here and add in additional custom colors as well. All right, so now we're going to fill it, and so we changed it all to blue. So you saw that it was previously green, now it is blue. All right, so just a quick note. Anytime you're working in a document, that document is automatically saved to your Google Drive. Your drive is usually still going to be open in a separate tab. So right now we're in Google Sheets, but if you look over here, like, you also have Google Drive. So you see your drive and it is there and you can see it. And you can click over there and just go back and forth as you need to. All right. All right, so now we're back at the drive. So we click the tab. Now we're back at the drive. You can see that your to-do list is here. And if you look really closely, you can also see that the cells have changed into what we just added in. So you see the three people and the new column that was created. So that's a preview, it's a snapshot of what just happened. Really quickly, because I don't think we go over this, when we're looking at this screen, as a new user of Google, as a someone with a brand new drive, you should have 15 gigabytes of storage information, storage available to you. So as you are creating different files and folders and things like that, those files and folders are going to add up to the size of what your total drive is going to be. So it eventually starts eating away at that 15 gigabytes, and then Google has some options for you to increase that storage if you should ever hit capacity, which is pretty easy to do if you're involved in like media and you put a lot of files and folders out there. All right, so now we're going to move on. So that was a quick dive into Google Sheets, okay? So now we're going to move on to creating an agenda for your summit or your meeting with Google Docs. All right. So imagine that you need to pull all the people that you're going to pull together. So those three people, those are on your team. They're on your committee. You need to have a useful and productive meeting and want to be able to keep notes during your meeting. So you're going to use Google Docs. We're going to create a sheet and then share meeting notes and then collaborate within the document from anywhere. All right. So how do we access Google Docs? Well, we are going to go back to our drive. So this is our drive. And we're going to click on New. And then we're going to click on Google Docs. So you're going to come down here to the menu. You'll see all the different tools that we're using today. And they're going to be down here. You're going to click on Google Docs. And remember to click over here because we're using templates for this session because it's just a lot quicker. Templates get you going a lot faster. So you're going to click on from a template. And then you're going to select the right template. Okay. So you're going to look for the meeting notes template. And so you're going to find the one that you want and then open that up. All right. There's a lot to choose from. If you want to just create your own, though, you can always do that as well. Right. So we've chosen one, and that is, it's a kind of bland one, but that's all right, because we're just going to use this as our kind of guiding post for where we're going. All right, so now you can update your text in the meeting agenda. So you can add in different text, you can make alterations and changes, you can change colors. So we're going to do all that kind of stuff. All right, so first up, what happened at the last meeting? Well, if you're just now creating this, you may not have had a last meeting. So you can also just delete certain things. But if you do want to add in some different information, you can do that here. You can format your text, okay? So formatting your text, it allows you to do that in the exact same way that you were able to do it over in Google Sheets. So you're going to come up to your formatting bar here, and then you're going to select however you would like to tailor the text that you see. And so we're going to select the text, and you just highlight that with your cursor, your mouse. You're going to copy and then select what you want to change, and then come up to the formatting bar, choose the color that you would like it to be, and then change it. So select the color icon up here, the font color icon, and then you're going to change the color of the text. Okay, so I would be choosing green if this was me, but, you know, this is pre-created, so we're using blue. That's fine. We're going to insert a comment. And that comment, again, you can use this in a really good way. I used to be the director of professional services for a software company that specialized in the federal bid capture and propose process. And so in that process, there's something called commenting. So you come together and you comment on a proposal or, maybe a RFP, a request for proposal, an RFI, something like that. So you come together and you put in your notes. And then, you know, once everybody's notes are in, then you go in and you define and recraft and recreate your document a little bit more. So this is exactly how you do that. So you select your text, and then over on the right-hand side, you see that little plus icon, and click that plus icon, and it adds in a comment there. And so you're able to leave a comment on that text without altering it, which allows your team to come in and say, oh, well, you know, so-and-so had something to say about this, so let's see what they had to say. Plus, it creates a history, and it enables you to track your thought process on how you viewed the document in its original state. And then Google does a great job of versioning as well. All right, so to do that, you're going to go ahead and click on a comment, and then you can select text and then create a new comment. So if you want to, you can add in a team member, so you can add in their name. If they're already in your workspace or if they've been granted access to a specific document to share. So you can add the plus followed by their email address. And that will, what do we call that? We call that tagging. They will tag them to the document. All right. So how do you share this? So let's say that we're done. Now we have gone through a variety of different things, and now we are done and we want to share this out. So to give your teammates access to this document, you're going to click on share in the upper right-hand corner of the document, and then you're going to select the access level, okay? So this is so much better than having to download a document and then send it out over email, which is insecure a lot of times. And then pray that somebody gets it, and then hope that they have the right tools on their system to open it up, and then wait for them to send it back to you, or be sent a PDF and not be able to alter it in any kind of way. Share the document. It makes collaboration a whole lot easier. So you're going to share this with someone else. So when you share it, you're going to click on share in the upper right hand corner, select the share access level, and then you're going to add a comment and click send. So the comment that you're adding is basically telling them why you're doing this. So tell people why you're sending them documents. Don't just send them documents, because that is nerve-wracking to a lot of people who just get stuff. And like me, like I keep things in my inbox, and so it makes it easy for me to like search and sift through things. And when people don't put comments on stuff, it is really nerve-wracking. That's all I'm gonna say. So add a comment and then click send. All right, so you can see right here though, they put in a comment, and that comment was, here's an agenda for our meeting. Down here, you have an agenda, and that's actually the attachment. So you're sending the document to them using the power of Google connected connected services and products, okay? So you're gonna click on that. Now, sharing information is, it's vital that we do this. So I'm just going to read this verbatim because I don't want to skip anything. All right. So when you're sharing files in your drive, you can give access to different files to different people. You can give different people different types of access. Maybe you want everyone who's helping you to see the meeting agenda. I'm going to show you that on the left side of your screen. But you also have the budget or the to-do list that we put together, and you only want one other person to have access to that. So that's what we're gonna show on the right-hand side of the screen, okay? So those are the two different ways that you're gonna be able to access this information. The great news is that yes, you can give different people different types of information. You can share data or share this document differently. So people have access to edit the file. They can comment on the file without being able to edit it, or they can just view it without the ability to comment or to make changes. So I will tell you right now, this is one of the things that trips people up the most. It is one of the things that can really go wrong when you're collaborating with folks, is you send them something, but you didn't give them the right access. So like they have to come back to you, and it's just a time drain. So be more efficient, learn this piece, do this right from the beginning, and then you'll be able to be successful. So you can give people access to a complete folder, and all of the files and folder, all the folders and files inside of that folder will also have that same set of access that you gave them. So everyone who has access to that folder will have access to the files that are inside of it. Okay? And yes, you can give access to people outside of your owner's list. So what this also means though is that you need to be careful who you're giving permission, especially if you're a business owner utilizing this for Google Workspaces. So be mindful of who's allowed to share things out, because they can give things outside of your organization, and that can be troublesome depending on what you're storing in the workspace, all right? So here we go. All right, so right here you're going to share, and then down here you're gonna add in their name, so that's not different, but over here on their left-hand side you're gonna click on editor. And then when you click on editor, you see that editor. Oops, oh, I left. You're gonna see editor, and then you can also change this. So you can change it to view, or you can change it to view with comments, and then give them the right access. You can also choose not to notify them that you're giving them access. So sometimes you just kind of want to see what happens. I always recommend notifying people. And then again, this is the message that gets sent out, and the agenda that gets sent out. One thing we didn't talk about is up here and in the upper right hand corner. This is a little bit more advanced, but you can come up to this little cogwheel up here, which is your settings for this particular share, and you can make additional adjustments. So sometimes that's important, so just be mindful that that option is there as well. All right, cool. So now we're going to go to our third application, and that application is building a presentation, or is Google Slides, and we're going to be building a presentation with Google Slides. All right, so now you have learned how to create a to-do list with Google Sheets. You've learned how to create an agenda with Google Docs. Now we're gonna learn how to use Google Slides, all right? So Google Slides is the way that you present. I'm presenting right now using the power of Google Slides, okay? So how do you do that? Well, everything starts in your Drive. So remember, you can access all the different types of cool applications that you can put together from Google in your Google Drive. You're gonna come to your Drive and then click on New, and then you're gonna click on Google Slides, and then you're gonna choose Template, because again, we're using templates because they're fast and easy and they're gonna get you going right away. And then we want you to search for status report. So there's a whole bunch of cool different things here, but when you look at it, we want you to find status report, okay? And I'm not seeing that on screen, so if you are seeing what I'm seeing, then you may have to scroll a little bit to find it, but it should be there. Oh, never mind. It is called Presentations That Stick. So I'm actually going to take a screenshot of this because that's not true. So we just had a kerfluffle, but that's all right. We're going to be adding presentations that stick, and that's what we're going to do. So that is apparently a status report type of template, but it is not called that on when you're seeing it from that view. All right, so the first thing you're going to do is create a title slide. Okay, so that's the first thing you actually see. So when you come in here, you should be able to go ahead and change the name to the status report for your specific project, your specific event, or your, you know, whatever the objective is, you're gonna change the name. And so to do that, in slides, I think it's important to know that this is a little bit different from what we just went over, which was Google Sheets. In Google Sheets, you have a spreadsheet, and that spreadsheet has cells. And each of those cells are things that you can click on. They have names. And so those names of those cells are going to be things like A1, A2, A3, depending on the column and the row that the data is corresponding with. In Google Slides, this is a presentation, and so this is all about words and graphics and inputs, right? So you can put videos in here. These are all going to be formatted in such a way that they are visually stimulating. So when you're here, you're going to be able to click on these little template tags or entry fields, and you're going to be able to select that and then tailor it to what you need. So you do still have to select it. I think the right word I'm looking for is placeholder, but each of these is going to be a specific placeholder for a specific type of object or media that you're going to put in there. Okay. So you can edit the text and then explain the purpose of what you're doing, adjust any dates as needed. All right. Okay. So next up, every template has pre-designed layouts, and that's true no matter what app you're using, even if you're not using a Google app. If you're using a template, there is something pre-designed for you to use, right? In Google Slides, your layouts have pre-arranged text boxes and formatting. Slides makes suggestions for how to use each of those layouts, okay? So again, you can create that title slide and then select your different layouts, and it will present you with a variety of different options. You can select the different layouts that you want to present depending on the type of info you're putting out there. So if you have a main point, or you want to do a video, or display like a chart or a graph, you can do that. So to add a new slide, you're going to go ahead and click the plus button. Okay, so up here at the top, you've got plus. Okay, and there's actually a drop down there, so you could click that too. But when you click on plus, you have your different types of available layouts for each of these slides. So if you actually, let me go back just for a second. I'm going to come back and then come back. Okay. So when we're here, oops, I already did it. Okay, there. Let me go back now. So when you're here, you're actually able to see, and actually, I'm just going to go back. There. So when we're here, you're actually able to see the different layouts on screen. Okay, so you see that like this is so that you can present a visually stimulating graphic. This one is for your title slide. Okay, so these are each called slides. Each one of these is a different type of slide. And then when you come here and you click the plus, you can choose which type of slide you want to represent. So like this one is awesome. It is for a section title with a description. If you have a main point, this is the layout they recommend. If you have some really cool numbers, like statistics you want to put out there, you can pop in this one. All right. So that's how you use those. And we are going to use the big number one. And then you're going to add in visuals. Okay. So when you come, after you've selected that slide, it inserts, remember that word, it inserts a new slide here. And it puts it in place where you were. And so you can add in new visuals there. So insert also allows you to insert something into this particular presentation slide or layout. So if you want to, you can insert an image. If you want to, you can insert some audio or video. So this is just kind of recapping what I just got done saying, but all of those things are available for you to do, and they make your slides and your presentations super cool. All right, so you can make sure that you have the right to use any images that you're using. So you may not always have this right, but it's important to try to actually validate that you have those rights to use imagery. All right, so you're gonna click on image, and then it gives you options. So you can upload it from your computer, you can search the web, you can pop out to your drive. You can also use your own photos that you may have taken that link to your phone if you're an Android user. Or you can add it in by a URL, or you can take a picture with your camera. So you have lots of different options for adding in images. We're gonna go ahead and search the web. And so when you do that, it pops out over to Google Images. Now, Google is a very big monster. It's not just regular Google. Like, there's a ton of different things out here that you can use, and this is one of them. If you don't know how to use Google Images, we're definitely going to be having a class on that some point before the end of the year so that people understand the options and availability that are out there. Google Images is, ooh, man, it's a monster, but it's available for you to use on a daily basis. And I would have been lost without Google for a lot of the different things that I like to do. All right, so we found one. And we're gonna go ahead and click it, and then that inserts it directly into my template. Okay, so you can then, kind of shift it, make it look better. You can add in all sorts of different things. But right now, we're gonna go ahead and say, okay, that's good enough, and we're going to share this out. So when you're sharing a presentation, don't forget that you can customize your text, you can add charts, you can add images, and you can add other visuals and stuff to enhance that, GIFs if you like, memes if you like. But we want to share it at this point. So now we're going to go ahead and share the slide deck with our team. Or you can make it available to everyone from the audience. So you can embed your presentation on a web page if you like to. So those are some really cool options that not a lot of other slide type of or presentation type of products give you. All right, so to access your settings, you're going to click on the share icon. So this is not dissimilar to what we just did. So we just did this a minute ago, so we're going to do it again. So you're going to find share, and it's usually over on the right-hand side in the corner. Share, it's yellow because they want to give you a caution because you're going to be sharing this information with someone else. So depending on how, excuse me, so depending on how you're sharing it, that person may be able to alter your presentation. And if you don't want that, then make sure that you are selecting the right type of share. To give them the right type of access. All right. So this is the same thing we did before. You're seeing that on screen. Now here's where, and that was really fast. So I'm gonna let this run one more time before we move on to another slide. Here is where you're actually able to see the drop down where you can choose between an editor or someone who can make comments or someone who can just view. So we're asking the question, can you please let me know what you think of this presentation by leaving a comment? And now he's going to go up to the upper right hand corner, watch, and click commenter. So that person can leave comments. They cannot make changes. So again, make sure that you're sharing the right way. And then you're going to send it. Now, instead of sending it, you can also give it to anybody with a link. So if you want to give a link to somebody down at the bottom when you're going to share this, it actually has the words get link. And so you can click on that. And then there's additional options, and you can copy that link and then give it over to somebody. Like, you can post it on the web, or you can post, we already talked about this, you can send it over an email if you like, or put it in Discord, and it will come up with a thumbnail and things like that to let people know what's coming. On this one, it's saying that it's restricted and only added people can with the link can access it. You can actually change that. There's a blue hyperlink right below that that allows anyone with the link to share it. So, or to access it, not to share it. So that's important too, because once somebody has access, you cannot, there's no good way to prevent that person from coming back into the document. You can take away their access if you've named their access, but it's kind of funky. So be mindful when you're sharing that you're not going to want to do that too often. All right, so recap and resources. Let's go through this one more time. So recap, Google Sheets. I hope you're comfortable with sharing your sheets and your documents, but at this point, we've already talked about how to create a to-do list in Google Sheets. We've learned how to plan a whole entire event. We have talked about how to create an agenda using Google Docs and some formatting and things that you can do to help speed things up, like use a template. We talked about placeholder text and how to customize your colors and add comments and to collaborate. And then we've also talked about Google Slides. So we reviewed Google Slides, and you had the opportunity to insert some imagery and learned how to make your presentation, your pitch deck, or anything else that you're doing look like it was done by a professional. Like, you went out and had somebody on Fiverr do it. So we're gonna explore other ways to do things. We do have a variety of different apps available to us as people. So we are, over the next several months, so from now until the end of the year, we are going to be having several of these types of workshops. So every Tuesday, every Thursday, there will be a workshop where we are coming together and learning how to use something that that is easily accessible and available to each of us to help us along our digital journey to skill up. So there's a few here. These are not at all of them, but you do have access to Google Forms, so you can create surveys. You can use Google Sites to create websites. Google Calendar helps you manage your calendar and your schedule so that when you're planning that event, you can make sure that you're actually going to it and on time, especially for all those meetings and things that you're doing. And then, of course, Google Meet, because Google Meet is one of the newer add-ons to the Google Suite, but it allows you to connect with your video. And since Duo and Google Meet have joined forces now, there's some really cool, fun things there that you can do inside of Google Meet to spice up some of your presentations and sessions and presentments. We've barely touched the surface of all the things that you can do with Google. So Google applications have a whole lot to offer, and I hope that you've been thinking about how you can use certain tips and tricks and tools to enhance both your personal productivity as well as your workplace productivity. So that is what it is all about. I want you to think about all the topics that we covered today. Write down at least one thing that you know or didn't know before we started this session. How can you take advantage of the things that we went through? And then what's your plan of action? So that's a lot, that's a mouthful, but think about how you can utilize the information that was shared today to help you become a stronger employee or a better business owner. And if you'd like to share that, you can type it into the chat wherever you are. I should be able to see it no matter where you're watching us. So we've got a lot of different moving parts here. I am absolutely thankful that all of you guys are here and that we are able to do this, and we can do that in part through the power of Google. So that's actually pretty cool. So we want you to keep learning on YouTube. So right now there are opportunities to grow with Google. You can go out to grow with Google on the YouTube channel for expert tips regarding your skills, your career, your business. A new video drops every Thursday. Like I said, we are going to be having sessions every Tuesday and Thursday from 9 to 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So Black Multiverse has also partnered with Google. We have and we will be presenting Google Career Certificates to our employees. So I told you earlier that we are hiring. Our employees are able to obtain professional certification through Google at no cost. If you are not an employee of Black Multiverse the position for you hasn't just come up yet, that's not a problem. You can still prepare for a career in 6 months with your professional training designed by Google. So you can learn at your own pace. There's no requirements for experience. You can stand out to your employers and then also get on a path to some in-demand jobs, because those jobs are out there. Data analytics, marketing and e-commerce, IT support, project management, and UX and UX design. Those are the spaces where we are helping people to skill up with our Google Career Certifications. Okay, so Grow with Google, it's an initiative all about helping people to prepare for work, find jobs, and grow in their business. If you're a job seeker, you can grow your skills to find new jobs and advance in your career. If you're a teacher, you can learn how to put technology to work inside and outside of a classroom. If you are a small business owner, you can build your online presence and find new customers. Startups get to learn how to get your ideas the exposure they need to succeed, and developers will be sharpening their current skills and mastering new ones. So take an opportunity to take your code to the next level. I love that. All right, so I have a whole ton of resources. I'm going to pop these into Discord so that people have access to them, so that those who attended have access to them. And then we're going to just say thank you. So I want to say thank you to everybody who is here and who attended. I do want to just really quickly bring this up one more time, and that is the fact that we are absolutely a Grow with Google partner, and we are absolutely dedicated to ensuring that we've got a future that includes folks with some skills and some knowledge and capabilities to help us drive into the future. So give me just a second. I'm trying to handle my screens over here. I've got like 45 different browsers and tabs and stuff open. So sorry about that. I am definitely a power user. And so with that comes a special kind of responsibility. Guys, we have some really cool things that are consistently going on, and we're able to provide that to our community. Our community is Blackverse, and Blackverse is dedicated to the education, the training, and advancement of the culture around the decentralized metaverse and multiverse. So this opportunity is definitely a part of that. This is the education piece. And so never at any point in time does education live on one side or the other, whether it's Web 2 or Web 3. It is something that is constantly, you need to constantly seek out and constantly be trying to achieve. This has been Digital Skills for Everyday Tasks. If you're interested in Black Multiverse or joining us in Blackverse, please do reach out to me. You can reach me at info@blackmultiverse.io. And I want to leave you with our saying, and that saying is that you should never be limited by other people's limited imaginations. Thank you so much for popping in. And thank you for joining us today. If you have questions, please send those over to info@blackmultiverse.io. I did not see any new ones come into the chat, but that's all right. So that means we did a good job, right? So look forward to that. If you are watching later on YouTube, first of all, don't forget to like and subscribe. And then second of all, if you have questions, you can pop those into the chat. And if you don't want to put them out publicly, you can email them over to info@blackmultiverse.io. So thank you so much. I want you guys to all have a wonderful day. Don't forget to, if you're in Discord, register for Thursday's session. We were going to do this one again, but I think we're going to do a new skill up program. So be on the lookout for what that is. I'll post it in Discord by the end of tonight. And don't forget to catch up with us and all the things that we are doing. We have some amazing things coming through. And yeah, so I appreciate you all. Have a great rest of your day. This is Nicole. My voice is resting.